get started. So we'll start with a standing warm-up. I'm going to just pop you guys on mute and share some sound. We'll have a nice little relaxation at the end. Okay, so we've got a Max Richter album. So can everyone hear me over the music okay? Just give me a thumbs up. All right, so if you can start by taking your feet open and just soften with your knees. And we're gonna lift our shoulders up to our ears, squeeze and then press down. So coming up, squeeze, and then down. Breathing in as you lift, and out as you press down. So deep breath in, breathing out as you press down, kind of verbalize your breath. Take it into a side lean. So if you drop your hand down the one leg, notice if you're leaning your body forwards, try to just lean off to the side. And we're going to hang down for 3, 2, 1. Come back up. So let your head go a bit of rag doll like. Let it flop and then lift. Adding in an arm, so we reach through the fingers and then open the arm, still reaching. So reach through the fingers and then open. Breathing in on the reach, breathing out as you open. Just opening up through the side of the body, keeping your body weight in your feet planted well down. There's no shifting of body weight in your feet, aiming for nice evenness through the left and through the right. One more on each side. So final one. And then let's do some mobilization for our shoulders. If you can find a stick or a band. So if you can take your stick behind, I'm going to touch down on the back and then pull on the stick and touch down at the front. If you're having to bend your arms and it's a little bit tricky to go over, go right to the edges of your stick. Just do it with your thumbs on there. If you can do a bit more advanced, then we wrap the fingers fully round like that. Particularly when you're at the back, with your stick, see if you can keep your fingers wrapped around for the tougher option. I'm going to add a tiptoe rise and then drop. So rising up, 2, 3, then drop. And as you do it, try not to let your back go into overarch. Tuck your bottom in and lengthen through your lower back. Breathing in as you take the stick behind, breathing out as you come forwards. And then we're going to pause the stick in front about hip height and just narrow the grip slightly. So about shoulder width with your hands. And I want you to tap up. So you're bringing your knee up towards the stick. And I want you to do it without sort of rocking like this from side to side. Imagine you've got a line down the front of your body and you stay in that line so that your upper body is staying quite steady. Point your toes as you do it to get your feet moving. And can you do it without any kind of dip in the middle? So lengthen your back. And last couple. Alrighty, and then placing the stick at the side, we're going to kick front, kick back. Now as you do the kicks, I want you to allow the midsection to be quite free. So you're going to round and then arch, round. You get a bit of height on it, a bit more lift. Point your toes quite firmly. Alrighty, let's switch the stick over the other way. So let's turn the heat up in here. So, kicks again. Allow your midsection to move. You arch your back and then round to mobilize your spine. Point your toes. Can you get a bit more height on your leg? Last couple. Alrighty, so holding onto the stick again, opening your feet just slightly wider than your hips, and if you can soften your knees. Can you move the stick so it sits vertically, then horizontally, and then vertically again, and then to the middle? I think we may take the ceiling out of here. We're in a lot of space. Tell you what, this bed is bigger than my house. Alrighty, so taking it around one way and then back the other way. And then try and get your rib cage moving more. So steady with your lower body, but upper body moving more. So you're sort of circling your upper body around, really sort of mobilizing the middle part of your back. That's feeling a bit tight today, getting your thoracics moving around your rib cage. And last one each way. Breathe. Okay, good job. So I'm gonna place our stick down and then turn the toes out slightly. So just sort of 45 degrees with the toes. We're going to drop into a plie and then lift. And do it again. Drop and then lift. And as you do it, think of your knees going directly over your smaller toes. We're going to hold down there for 3, 2, 1 and back up. Different to a squat where we lean forward, try to keep your body upright. 2, 1 and release. Now as you keep going, if you've got a band there, I want you to hold your band like this and you're gonna hold 2, 3 and then release. All right, so if you grab your bands, hands facing up and then pull 2, 3 and release. Lovely, let's do that again. So pull 2, 3 and release. And think of squeezing your shoulder blades towards each other as you pull on the band. Pressing your shoulders down away from your ears. You do that twice more. All the way down, 2, 3. And last one. 2, 3. And release off. Okay, great. So next, we're going to take the band and we're going to scoop it underneath our feet. You can do it without if you don't have a band. And we just sort of separate the band under your feet so there's a bit of pull as you hold. And then we're going to drop it to a squat, allowing the band to go floppy either side and then coming back up. And let's do that again. So coming down and sit back into your heels slightly. And let's do that again. Coming down, 2, 3. Now you can either let the band flop at the side or next level, we'll add a little bit of pull forwards. 2, 3. And release. And let's do that again. For more advanced, we add more height on the band. So you're going to pull and aim to get your hands above your shoulder line. 3 more. Last 2. And final 1. Alrighty, well done. So, feeling warmer, I'm sweaty. Have a little drink, Now's a good time. Okay, so if you can come and join me down on the mat now. Alrighty, so if you can come down onto your back, I'd like you to bring your knees towards your chest like that and see if you can try to lift your bottom off the floor. So you're going to tuck and then tap down. So we tuck and then tap. Keep your feet quite close to your bottom as you do it. So level one, I'm going to stick with this version. Level two, I'm going to add in a little roll up, elongate up through the posture. If you're doing this level, see if you can hover your feet off the floor. Now, if you're on a hard wooden surface, you might find doubling your mat over just gives your back a bit more padding. Level three, more advanced, we can sit and hold, and then tuck and roll. Breathing out on the roll, in on the lift. So verbalize your breath again. And last couple. Okay, good job. So let's flip over onto our front and we'll move into doing some cobras now. So if you can lay down onto your front, you point your toes out the back quite firmly, hands just slightly wider than your shoulder, and we're going to pull our shoulder blades down as we lift, hold, two, three, and then lower. Just pull your back, come up, pull your belly button muscle away from the ground as you lift and squeeze your buttock muscles. Particularly if you struggle with your lower back and it gets a bit niggly, apply those two principles. So pulling in through the belly button, squeezing through the glutes, inhaling on the lift, exhaling on the lower. Now, if you're feeling like you've got a happy back, a bit more height, chin up, eyelids roll back. Holding up there for three. And you can get your heels closer together. Two, one, and then coming down. So choose what feels safe and appropriate for today. Yeah, verbalizing the breath, inhaling, lifting. And exhaling slowly. So two more. Final one. Okay, so can we all meet up in the downward dog? I do think that would be a good name for a pup. So lots of lift, quite of green juice, please. Lift your bottom up in the air, feet a bit wider than your hips. And if you press your heels down, eye gaze towards your belly, just having a little check-in. Who's on the slide? She's on a bath mat. So have a little check-in. How are your calf muscles feeling today? Deep breath. We're gonna drop the body weight like this into one side and flex the toes on the other. So then let's switch to the other side. So we wanna get on that leg that's got the bentness of the knee. Try and push your toes downwards and then switch so that we're flexing and mobilizing our toe joints. For me, sometimes they can feel a bit stiff if they've been squished into shoes all day. They have the sandals on most of today. Let's switch the other side. And one more each way. Breathe. So final one. Alrighty, so you'll need a cushion, one cushion or just a general cushion from the sofa for this next one. So I'm going to park it just here between the knees and then you get to have a lie down. Okay, so if you can pop down onto your backs for me. Great. Palms facing up, we're going to roll up into a shoulder bridge. So like a bit squeeze from behind and get your hips lifted. The cushion now. And then imprinting middle, back and lower back to come down. So try not to come down as a block in your spine. Let's do it again, rolling up. And this time mentally really tune in to the movement as your spine comes down. Is it like a sneaking action or coming down a bit more like a circle? Let's do that again, rolling up. Hold, two, three, and then imprint middle back, lower back to come down. Let's do that again. When you're up there, we'll just squeeze your pelvic floor. So it'll feel like you're holding one in, two, three, and then imprint down and let your pelvic floor relax. Squeeze your pelvic floor on the way up. So get a set of pelvic floor exercises in on this one. Doctors, physios tell us we should be working on these daily for maintenance or more sets if we need to work on strengthening down there. So this one, we're going to roll down, and then if you meet me at the top, and we'll stay there. So I want you to hold at the top, and can you keep your hips level as you float one foot off the floor? Place your foot down, and can you float the other foot off the floor? You can stay with the basic version, and then imprint middle back, lower back to come down. Let's do that again. So level two, we hover the foot. To level three, we extend the leg. Try and keep the cushion squeezed. Place the foot back on the floor. Repeat the other side. Don't let the hip drop. Pointy toes, back in, and roll back down. Let's do that again. So curling up. When that foot stays on the floor, push it down firmly into the ground. Same on the other side. Activation. Our extensor muscles down through the lower back, the glutes and the hamstrings, coming back up. One more on each side. Ooh, losing the cushion, I'll squeeze harder, note to self. Rolling back down. So from there, our cushion away, and if you can now extend one leg like this up in the air. That's it, can you point your toes quite firmly? And then we'll place opposite hand here on the calf. Lovely. Can you place your other hand just behind your thigh? Now, would you keep hold of that leg and really point quite firmly? So you're now pressing your leg into your hands, straightening your bottom leg down. Now, can you bring that leg a little closer to you? More advanced version, we're going to bring our nose and our knee together. Breathe. Release up. Okay, good job. Let's do that on the other side. So opposite hand on the calf, pointy toes. Work at straightening that leg and reaching down bottom leg there. So straight leg on the bottom leg first, level two. Now push your hands and your leg firmly together. So it feels like there's kind of tension at the same time as working on the stretch. Bring your nose and your knee together. If you keep that bottom leg on the floor, breathe. Just exploring your flexibility. Alrighty, resting on. So next up, we're gonna slide our fingertips into the curve of the lower back. So we use the hands to just be aware of the core. So if you can pull your belly button muscle in. And I'd like you to bring your feet quite close in, lifting your knees, and as you lower your feet, can you keep your pressure on your hands? How's it feel? Do it again, exhaling and lifting, and inhaling as you lower. Can you keep your pressure on your hands? Out on the lift, and in on the lower. Explore your core by taking your feet just a little further away, and you keep good pressure still on your hands. Where do you kind of get that shaking spot? You slow it down through the shaking point to strengthen the muscles there. Press your shoulders back, open your collarbone. try and avoid grounding. Shoulders forwards, breathe. Bringing your right knee up to your chest, but extending your other leg quite long. That's it. Now with your opposite hand, can you bring your knee across your body and place your foot down here on the floor? That's it. And then this arm over here behind, I'm gonna leave trailing just slightly higher than the shoulder. You turn your head to look towards your back arm. Press your knee down and your shoulder down quite firmly. Breathe in. Again, press down firmly as you exhale. Do it again. Press down. Okay, good job. Let's give that a go on the other side. Can you switch the knees? So, opposite hand, bringing the knee across the body. That's it. Feel for the floor with your foot. You trail this arm behind, eye gaze looking towards your back hand. Pressing down, deep breath in. As you exhale, press down the shoulder and the knee more firmly. And again, deep breath. And one more deep breath. Okay, good job. So now's a good time to get a drink. So let's stay topped up, hydrated. And we're gonna move up to standing. So I'd recommend you do the next bit with a stick because we're gonna use it for some posture work. So up we come. Okay, so you can place your stick behind your back. You've got one hand in the curve of your lower back and one hand just by your neck. We're gonna go long with your back leg. And if you can get a good gap between your feet. Oh, we nearly lost a Rodney. He's back, great. Okay, so can you square up your hips and bend into your front knee as you come down? Now, as you hold it there, if you could see yourself from a side view in your screen, does your stick look upright? That's it. Can you straighten your back leg? And we're gonna come back up, straightening the front leg, and then bend into front leg. Can you come all the way down but keep your knuckles and your lower back together? Allow your back leg to straighten. Breathe. And coming back up. And we're going to do that again. So knuckles and lower back together as you come down. Extending through your back leg. Hold, breathe. Alrighty, and then from there, can you drop your back knee to the floor? I'll just bring my camera down a little bit so you can see what's happening. Okay, so back knee on the ground. I'm gonna park the stick just here on the other side. So we'll use that for a little bit of balance. Depending how much padding you've got under your knee, you might want something underneath your knee needed. You could roll your mat up and be quite uncomfortable. So heel towards your bottom. And notice on the back foot, is your hip wandering back? Can you rotate that hip forwards? Heel towards your bottom. see yourself in your screen. Can you get your shoulders stacked up above your hip? Deep breath in through your nose and out through your mouth. And again, deep breath. Can you get the heel closer in? And let's release off. Okay, good. So let's turn around. We're going to move into our lunges the other way. So make sure you've got your other foot at the front. Shoulders, tailbone against your stick. You square up your hips as you come down. That's it. Just pushing the back of your head towards the stick. And can you elongate now through your back leg? Squaring up your hips. Breathe. Let's lengthen the front leg out. Coming down, as you come down, notice where you feel that stretch. What happens when you square up the hip a little more? Breathe. How does it change the stretch as you straighten out through your back leg? Breathe. And let's come back. And do that one more time. Coming down. Squaring up the hips. Breathe. Straightening the back leg. Ready. So from here, if we can drop our back knee down. So if we use the stick this side just to steady ourselves. Again, if you need a bit of extra padding under the knee, a block or a cushion, something just to give you a bit of extra comfort on this. So heel towards the bottom. For me on this stretch, I feel like I sort of squeeze from behind, push the hip bones forward to really initiate the stretch. So you might want to play with a bit of clenching. Always good fun. Breathe. Now, if you can see yourself from a side view, is your shoulder sitting in front like this? You get your shoulder to sit back over your hip. Heel towards your bottom, a little bit further if you can. What's doable today? Alrighty, let's rest off. Come to a seated position like this. Suitably sweating. It was definitely warmer in the UK when I left, but it's cooled down a bit. Okay, so we're going to take our hands just here behind our back. So placing your hands down. And to begin with, I'd like you to just work at straightening your arms, like really fully, like you're trying to push the ground away. And then lift your chest. That's it. Feeling for the floor with your feet. We're just going to wriggle our feet slightly further away. And then relax and bend the elbows. So, straightening the arms like you're pushing the ground away. And squeeze your shoulder blades backwards towards each other. Level two, so we're going to lift the bottom. And over time, you could aim for some height. So if you can see yourself on screen, we're looking for a line from the chest through the hip to the knee and then back down. Alrighty, so arm straightening first, push the ground away. Next level, we lift, squeeze, hold, breathe, and come down. Now if you want to, you can add your cushion back in. You park it here between the knees. And as you do the lift, add some squeeze on the cushion. More advanced, we'll do it with straight legs. So choose your level. Can be quite tough on the arms and shoulders, this one. Go easy if you've got any neck or shoulder issues. So if you can hold up for 3, 2, 1, and then down. We do two more, and then we'll have a little shake out and some water. So last one, nice deep breath as you do it. Okay, good job. Give your arms a shake, have a little drink, and then we'll have a little stretch for our glutes. How are we doing for time? I've normally got my big clock in my studio. There we are. Okay, so let's come down onto our backs, and we're going to give our glutes and the side of our hips a stretch. Let's nudge the camera down there. Okay, so right leg over left for me. If you can feel for your ankle bone on top of the leg, that's quite a useful kind of bony marker to use on this one, if you want to call it that. And then fingertips around the back of your thigh. Use your hands to pull the leg in. And you push out with your elbow. And I'd like you to take a moment just to score that stretch, like scale of 1 to 10. 10 being, oh, unbearable. Where are you on that effort scale? And get it to about a 7. Now, sometimes on this stretch, I notice I wander off a bit to one side. So see if you're kind of off to one side. Can you centralize your body as we go into the next level where we're interlacing our fingers just around the front of the shin here. And we pull in just a little more firmly. Keep pushing out with the knee. Breathe. Do this the next one in stages. You can either stay with this or next level, opposite hand over here is going to place on the top foot. So if you can do that for me first, opposite hand on the top foot there, that's it. And then take this hand in the middle out and around to catch hold of the other foot. And then from here we'll bring both feet down to the floor and slide your shoulders down your body. Pushing your bottom leg, if you can, to the ground. I think we've lost a Lorna on the back there. It'll come back. Keep practicing. And then the top knee, we're going to push the leg out of the way. That's it. So just feeling for the stretch. Lift your breastbone as well. Breathe into your belly. Staying here for one more deep breath, let your belly fill, empty, use this as your breathing space today. Alrighty, so from here, if we can switch left over right, again, feeling for that little bony area of the ankle, just on top of the thumb. So you interlace your fingers around the back of the leg, push out with the left elbow. Use your left elbow to push out, use your hands to pull in to initiate the stretch. And again, you might want to just score it. Is it a 6? Is it a 7? Is it an 8? Is your body weight centralized? Press your shoulders back and breathe. We interlace the fingers, so around the front. Keep pushing the knee outwards. Deep breath. Opposite hand on the top foot. We can get hold of the other foot. Both feet to the floor. Again, you can stick with that first foot or second version. We're doing the third one.
It's all right. Absolutely fine.
Yeah. Drop your bottom knee down. Push your top knee away. And can you squeeze your shoulders towards each other? Lift your breastbone. Close your eyes. Breathe into your belly. As you breathe, just appreciating a little bit of time spent, giving yourself a good old stretch. Alrighty, let's release off. Back to working our core. If you can park your hands around the back of your head here. Tap your opposite knee and your elbow like this together. So nice and easy. One elbow stays on the floor as the other one comes up and taps the knee. Level two, we start to alternate the legs. So either level one or two, you choose. And then level three, we extend the leg. Breathing in for two and out for two. In for two and out for two. Two more breaths. Last one. Alrighty, and then full body stretch. Point your toes, if you can interlace your fingers and arch backwards, little finger side to the floor. Breathe into your belly. One more deep breath. Okay, good job. So next up, can you roll over? We're going to come onto our fours, and we're going to move into a plank. So we're going to bring our elbows down. Notice the hip has come forward. And if you can see yourself from a side view in your screen, really you want your bottom and your shoulders about the same height. Pulling in from your belly button and then coming up to your hands, keeping your shoulders pulled down. So we're going to come down to your elbow and then up to your hand. Down to your elbow, up to your hand. Now you can keep going with your knees on the floor. That may feel enough for you. Or you can do it from your toes. Now see if you can keep your hips from rocking as you do it. Breathe. Last couple. And then from here, we're going to meet up in a groin stretch. So knees have gone open, just slightly wider on the mat, feet together. Elbows are down. We're going to let the back arch. And then just push your body slightly back, just back until you feel a good old stretch around your groin. I'm just going to push the right knee more firmly into the ground for about 5 seconds and then release that pressure. Do the same on the left. Breathe and just release that pressure. From here, we're going to hook the toes under, move into our downward dog again. So feet just slightly wider than the hips, head drop. When you let go of your neck, your shoulders. Breathe, pressing the heel of the hands quite firmly into the mat. And you press your heels down more firmly as you walk your hands in, and I'd like you to find a weight. Uncurl, come up to standing. So I did have a hunt around for what weight we could find, so I'm going to use a pineapple today, and Lorna's got a melon. So see what you've got. We're gonna finish off with some fruity squats. So feet just slightly wider than your hips. I'd like you to sink down, hold our weight in front, two, three, and then release. So again, coming down, two, three, and then release. If you wanna go higher, we'll take it up. Ooh, oh, lost a bit of the pineapple. let's do it again. Can we do four more? Last three, Two more. And final one. Can we hold? 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And let's release. Okay, good job. So we are nearly there. Let's come down onto our front. And if you can get hold of one of your feet, heel towards your bottom. You can push your hip bones down into the floor and press your pubic bone down into the floor as you bring your heel towards your bottom. So level one, keep the thigh on the floor. Level two, now lifting your thigh off the ground. So there's a gap underneath the bent leg thigh, but heel still on the bottom. Breathe. Third level, getting more height now, like this on the leg. Hip bones still weighted. Breathe. And let's release. Let's give that a go on the other side. So basic quad stretch, knees together, heel towards your bottom. Hip bones pressing down. Feel even pressure in your hips as you bring your heel towards your bottom. Breathe. And then once you've got your heel on your bottom, can you lift your thigh, still keeping the hip down and still keeping the heel there. Breathe. More advanced. Straighten the arm fully and roll the shoulder back. So we're now initiating stretch more in the bicep as well as the front of the chest on that arm that's holding the foot. Breathe. Alrighty, let's release off. I'd like you to come down onto your back and just rest your hands on top of your belly. If you can close your eyes, allow the body just to sink into the feel of the mat. Let's take a moment to notice different sensations in your body, the temperature, the sort of sweatiness, the energy in your body. Just doing a quick sort of before and after check. How is your energy now compared to the start of the session today? Shifted. The word comes up when you describe that shift in your head. To make a mental note of that word, that phrase. Allow your teeth to open. Center your attention on relaxing around your jaw, your tongue hang inside your mouth. Allow your body to kind of sigh. Scanning from the little muscles in your face down through your torso. Like a light of a slow photocopier scanning your whole body from top to bottom. With that light, imagining of healing energy drawing into your body, filling up all your cells with positive, healthy energy. Scanning down through all the internal organs, your bones, your muscles, space in your cells, down into the lower half. Relaxing down almost twice as much relaxed as you were before now. Allow your attention to drift away. Mentally in more relaxed, happy places. Noticing the sounds in that space. Noticing the more distant sounds. Attention back to your breathing. I'd like to take a deep breath in so that your hands fill up with air. And a long exhale. Keep blowing out until you can't blow out any more air. Just do that again. So filling up your hands with air. And a long exhale. Keep blowing out. Keep going. Keep going. Just do that one more time. Breathing, just settle back into its natural pace, opening your eyes. We're going to a little stretch for our neck, peep and roll to your side. Just take a little stretch for our neck before we have a check-in. So if you can take a seat, and we're going to allow the head to drop to one side, and then by your ear, if you can just gently pull with your hand, let your head sort of flop to the side, and release. Let's do that the other way. Again, just a gentle pull, which is how your neck is feeling. So do that pull. Alrighty, so if you can just hit your unmute for me.